When you see the cabin climate control system requires service in your Tesla, it means that most likely your heating and AC will not work. If you have a 2021-2022 model year, there is a service bulletin covering the issue with the refrigerant pressure and temperature sensor. It won't be covered unless the car is still under warranty, but anyway, with this TSB, you will at least know what to do. Also, it's not impossible that this is caused by wiring problems. It's especially common in cases with water intrusion under the frunk liner. Corroded connections in the climate control system will immediately send it to error mode and nothing will work. It's impossible to find a wiring issue on your own, so you will still need some help from your dealership. If you have problems with heating, you may manually turn on heated seats and the heated steering wheel. If you put them all on max, it would be pretty warm in your car after some time. Also, there were a couple of cases when the sensor of interior temperature failed in Tesla vehicles. I couldn't find any TSBs, so I don't think it's that common, and it's easy to inspect in the dealership because the sensor will store its own fault code in the system. If you're lucky and it's just a software glitch, you may reset the Tesla through the service tab in the menu, then press power off and then press the brake to start it again. It won't help if it's a broken sensor or wire, but if it's a software glitch, you may get your heating or AC back and keep driving in comfort. Anyway, even if the problem is intermittent and disappears on its own, you should have the vehicle inspected, as you may get into trouble with no heating on winter highways.